Yes, dear students, in the last class we have studied about the electrode-electrolyte interface and the structure of electrode-electrolyte interface we have studied. Today, the next topic we are going to discuss is electrical double layer. Electrocapillary phenomena. This can be easily explained by using Lippmann equation. Electrical double layer, we have studied in the last class that metal is this is metal over which the electrolyte ions gets diffused over the surface of the metal, and we have primary layer, secondary layer, and the diffused layer, and as a result the potential develops between the metal and electrolyte, and the potential difference arises. In the last class we have studied total potential difference between the metal and electrolyte is QLM. This we have studied in the last class. In the electrocapillary phenomena, what happens when the electrolyte and electrode is in contact with each other? There a potential develops. Not only that, the interfacial tension is also developed between the metal and the electrolyte. The interfacial tension is usually represented as gamma. This is because of the potential difference between the electrode and electrolyte contact. Okay? Sometimes the metal remains stationary. The electrolytic solution moves. Because of this, the potential arises is called electrokinetic phenomena or electrocapillary phenomena. Okay? Next we are going to study in this chapter, in this topic, we are going to study the electrocapillary phenomena using the Lippmann equation. Listen. Now we are taking the interesting system of electrode-electrolyte interface. Now if the system is closed one, for example, according to thermodynamics, dU, we know that formula, dU is equal to TdS minus PdV. This is for the closed system. For an open system, the same mathematical thermodynamic equation, I can write it as dU is equal to TdS minus PdV minus sigma mu I dNi. What is this mu I dNi? Chemical potential. Because in the open system, there will be change in the number of moles from the system to the surroundings. So therefore, I can write this equation as mu I dNi for an open system. Now let us consider the work done between between the electrode and electrolyte, between the metal surface and the liquid surface, okay, is the volume of expansion or the increase in the area of work is represented as gamma into dA. Gamma is interfacial tension. dA is the expansion of the area between the metal and the liquid. Okay. Next we have dQm is nothing but the charge transferring, okay, between metal and the electrolyte, charge transferring. By keeping all these things, okay, and modifying this equation as dU is equal to TdS minus PdV minus gamma into dA minus delta m1 ps phi dq dash m minus sigma mu I dm I. Okay, what is this? This is the potential difference between the electrolyte and the metal, and this dQm is a transferring charge over the surface of the metal, and this is the chemical potential. Now see, these factors in the left hand side, they are all intensive factors, and these factors are expensive factors. Intensive factors means these factors do not depend on the quantity of the matter, whereas these terms are expensive factors, that is, they depend on the quantity of the matter. So therefore I can write it as dU equal to, this is the summation of intensive factor minus summation of expensive factor or into expensive factor. What are the intensive factors? This intensive factor is temperature, pressure, okay, interfacial tension, potential difference, and chemical potential. Okay, expensive factors. Okay, the expensive factors, that is S, V, and A. These are all, that is, intensive factors. This is expensive factors. Not only that, equal to Qm and Ml. Qm, charge on the surface of the matter. All these are expensive factors. Now what happens? The internal energy of a system, I can write it as the differential form U is equal to Ts minus PV minus gamma A minus M1 S delta pi Q dash M into minus sigma mu I Ni. Okay? Then, on differentiating this equation, when I differentiate this equation, I will get TdS minus PdV minus gamma into dA minus M1 S phi dq dash m minus sigma mu a d n i is. Okay. And plus sdt minus vdp minus a into d gamma minus 2m into d m1s pi potential difference minus sigma ni mu dni. Okay, ni d mu i, ni d mu i. When we compare this equation with the previous equation, we get this value will be equal to 0. 0 will be equal to sdt minus vdp minus a d gamma minus qm to d potential difference between metal and electrolyte minus sigma ni d mu y. Or I can write this equation as d gamma, the change in interfacial tension, will be equal to minus dm.
M2
5 can be written as equal to minus 1 by ZI into F into D mu J. What is J? That is ZI, charge of the ith ion, and F is the Faraday. That is J is the particular species of the ion and ZI is the charge of the ion into Faraday. So therefore, on substituting these values in the potential difference between the metal and the electrolytic system, finally we can write the expression. That is D gamma is equal to minus QM into DV minus QM divided by ZAF into D mu J equal to minus tau I D mu I. Okay, this is the change in interfacial tension between the liquid and the metal. See, this is for polarizable interfaces. For polarizable interfaces, and this is called, tau I is called surface excess. This is interfacial tension. Tau I is surface excess. Remember, this is equal to surface excess. Okay? Then, I can write this equation for an electrocapillary substances. Okay? When the fixed composition is taken in the electrolytic solution, then the D mu I species will become equal to 0. Okay? When the D mu I for a fixed composition, what is in a fixed composition? There will not be any change in the number of moles of electrolyte. In that case, D mu I will be equal to 0. And therefore, what happens? Sigma of tau I D mu I will become equal to 0. Therefore, this equation follows that dou gamma divided by dou V divided by into a constant temperature will be equal to minus QM. See, that is change in interfacial tension with respect to volume at constant temperature is the decrease in potential or decrease in the charge created over the surface of a metal. This equation is called Lippmann equation. This Lippmann equation can be easily explained by using the electrocapillary cap. See, what is electrocapillary cap? When the surface tension or interfacial tension, okay, this surface tension is plotted against the surface tension is nothing but it is given in gamma in dynes per centimeter, dynes per centimeter is plotted against potential difference. Potential difference, okay, that is the potential is like 200, 0, then minus 200, minus 600, like this, and this is 380, 390, 400, that is interfacial tension 410. Okay, if I plot this scale and plot it, I will get a curve like this. Okay, the slope of this capillary cap, usually the slope is drawn like this. On touching this cap, okay, the slope is drawn by taking this angle is theta, okay. This angle is theta, then when we take the slope of this, tan theta will give you the charge on the metal surface, okay, and this value, usually this value will give the value of volume of expansion, okay. This value will give you the volume, that is the potential difference, at which potential difference there will be a maximum value at which the slope occurs can be obtained. So this V is nothing but the self potential. From the slope of this curve, we can easily find out the charge over the metal surface. This is known as what is called as Lippmann equation, which is very much useful to find out the variation of interfacial tension with respect to volume at constant temperature. Okay, in the next class we are going to study different models of electrical double layers. Okay, different scientists has given different models for electrical double layers. So in the next class we will study the electrical double layer theories of Helmholtz theory, Guy-Chapman theory, Perrin theory, okay, and Stern theory, and so on. Okay, so today we have studied the electrocapillary phenomena as well as the derivation of Lippmann equation, and using this Lippmann equation, how to find out the potential developed or the charge developed over the metal surface due to electrode-electrolyte interface. Okay, we will study the next topic in the next class.